How does it feel to be at the first one of these big fan events where you can talk really openly about being Black Canary and how that is? Because obviously, you've had a couple of interviews, but this is Comic Con.
Right. No, absolutely. It's freaking amazing. I'm like, finally, I can say it. I mean, it's completely fulfilling, and this character, this job, this role, this, you know, series has been a dream come true, and I really wanted to do that action and living in this genre, so I couldn't be happier.
Are you working out every minute of every day?
Oh, every minute of every day? No. No. I've been working out a lot and really, really hard, but I think it's cool because it makes it that much more realistic and believable. It also feels good to be in good shape and to know that I can kick anybody's ass.
So you do all your own stunts?
I try and do as much as I possibly can. There are obviously, there's insurance involved at some point where, you know, I shouldn't be jumping off rooftops, which is fine by me. But as far as physically and the fighting, I do as much as I can there, and as much as they let me. And I've been in martial arts training in Tampa's, and some of that people on my Instagram, I post about it.
Was it a relief to finally be part of all aspects of the show?
Yes, you have no idea. It was a long time coming, but I think it was the right thing to do. I think the writers wrote really well for me, and it was more believable. And as an actor, it was amazing because, you know, I wasn't season 2 the Black Canary overnight, you know? I had to go through hardship, and it made it that much more believable and realistic, and I was just doing what they were writing, and it was that much more helpful. When I finally became Black Canary, it was, like, all legitimate, if that makes sense. It felt more realistic.
What can you tell us about Laurel's arc this season and where she begins starting season 4?
We'll definitely see Laurel a lot more polished and good at, you know, being a quote-unquote superhero. She's obviously, last season she was a fighter, she's always been a fighter, but it was a lot more heart. And this season I think that it's not just heart, she actually has been training and working that aspect of herself and her superhero going out at night. And it's also been like a big role to take on along with Felicity and Dimmel, to take Oliver's position basically. And whether or not they're capable of doing that, you'll have to wait to watch season 4. But I definitely think Laurel will have play a big part on the influence of creating legends. Sorry, I didn't care how I worded that.
Yeah.
It was like, what can I tell you? But she does. She plays a big part in that, and I think you guys will all be surprised.
Are you able to tell us anything about Laurel's awareness of Sarah whenever she favors it?
No, I can't tell you that. No, I really can't tell you that, though. But I think that, you know, if Sarah got to see Laurel right now, I think that she would be proud of her, you know, for all the hard work she's put in. And I also think that she would be worried, probably, because she loves her sister and doesn't want her sister either. But I think she would definitely be rough. I know I am.
Are you going to miss the female bonding scenes between Laurel and Nyssa that we had last season?
Absolutely. I mean, Katrina's awesome, and I love working with her, and hopefully she'll come back. Who knows? It's television, right?
Well, their dynamic would have changed quite a bit, because now Nyssa reports to Malcolm Merlin, so she can't just kind of be her own woman and do her own thing and train her all she wants to.
Right, but it's still television, anything can happen. And it's right now, that's what she's doing, but I have a feeling there's going to be more to the story.
So there's going to be a lot of crossovers with Legends then?
I hope so. That would be awesome.